Daryn?
What?
I think we should do a reenactment of what our life was like before YouTube, before our YouTube channel.
They don't want to see that. I'm Daryn.
I'm Lori.
And we're of
Adventures of Daryn and Lori.
So come on an adventure with us. We never know where we're going, and we are unscripted and on the fly, but we will have fun.
Living in Mexico.
Living in Mexico. Hey,
I think that we need to tell people how we became friends.
Well, it is kind of a wild story. I mean, it is definitely supernatural. Yes. Okay.
Back in 2004, my family and I moved to Mexico to learn Spanish. We wanted to immerse ourselves into the culture and to understand the culture. And so we moved to the popular side of Guadalajara, and we were attending the second largest church. They had the most amazing musicians.
Yes.
Amazing. And immediately those musicians came around us and they said, hey, we'd like to work with you guys, and we'd like to do crusades with you guys, do outdoor events with you guys, but you have to stay and live here in Mexico and don't move away. And it was such a phenomenal offer that we couldn't resist. And now I had a Mexican band. It was these wonderful musicians from this church that were traveling around with us, and we went to visit different areas in Mexico and did outdoor events. And so in 2005, I was already recording in Spanish, even though I wasn't very fluent in the language. And I went onto MySpace so that people could hear the music that we were doing. And my cousin, he's in the music business. And so I was on his MySpace page. And I don't think Daryn remembers this, but Daryn asked to be my friend. And I thought, oh my goodness, who's this lady? And and I was looking at her MySpace, and she had all these beautiful pictures of Hollywood and these pictures with the band that my cousin had been playing in, which back in 1986, my cousin was playing in this band Striper that she was managing. I wrote to my cousin, I said, who's this lady? Who's Daryn Hinton? And he says, oh, she helped the band start out.
Striper.
She helped Striper start out, and she played a very important role. And so I was just so honored that she would want to connect on MySpace. But
also with the whole MySpace thing, I loved MySpace back in the day. I mean, it's ancient now, it doesn't exist, but it was Facebook is now type of thing. And it was really a great place. But you got my attention because you were ministering in Guadalajara. I love Mexico, and I had a business in Cabo San Lucas for 16 years, and was just amazed that this person that is connected through this rock band I love and adore, they're my babies, Striper, was ministering here. And so that's how you caught my attention.
When Facebook came out, she and I were connected through Facebook, but then we lost connection. So,
because it wasn't like we became really good friends, right, and we talked all the time. She just knew, oh, that's her. And I know, oh yeah, she's the one that ministers in Guadalajara.
Uh-huh.
Right.
So last year, what was last year? 2022.
Okay.
It was February. There pops up a memory, how Facebook has memories, and there's this memory, and it's from Daryn Hinton. And I had lost contact with her, so I was thinking, who is this message from? And I actually have that message right here.
Oh, you do?
I do.
Oh my gosh.
And I looked at it and I said, who is this lady? So I pushed the comment to look at it, and I saw Daryn Hinton. And then I was like, oh, the lady that worked with Brent. And then as I was clicking off, I noticed it said she lived in Ajijic, Mexico.
Yes.
And I had to go back and click on it, and I said, oh my goodness, she lives here. And she had just moved here. They had only been here for 1 week.
1 week.
And I said to myself,
the chances of that.
This is a God thing. So then I say, I have to greet her. So I send her a greeting, and I say, I can't believe you are here. And that was how we became.
Right. And I couldn't actually believe it. And then even to make things stranger, her church that her husband is the pastor at is 0.3 miles from my house. Are you kidding me? Mm-hmm. Okay, so do you think God might want us to be friends? Do you think he might have thought up this whole thing and the whole connection before any of it happened? Because it's just too strange. And a lot of times in your lives, all these amazing miracles happen with connections that you could not have possibly put together. And that's one of these to us. And we're really thankful of it, because when I'm with her, I laugh out loud at the top of my lungs, and we're really different. I mean, I eat anything, and she is plant-based and basically doesn't eat anything outside of that. She's a conservative Christian, and I'm not anymore. I love Jesus more than anything in the world, but we're so different. Yet, we're best friends, and we're having fun in Mexico together.
And we have a lot in common. She and I have been hanging out together for a year, and she tells the most fascinating stories. And I'm thinking, there should be a movie about your life, or your story needs to be told. And we're not getting any younger. One day we'll show you how our life was before we started making videos. My life was very chilled. It was, I was pretty much retired, and my pastime was playing some really cutesy video games. And actually one day I said to the Lord, is there anything else that you are wanting me to do? And then Daryn moved to town.
I was saying the same thing. I just want to feel passionate about something again, Lord, like I did about my rock bands with Striper and Holy Soldier and Charisma. And for some reason, this crazy connection happened. So we will see.
I enjoy hearing Daryn's story so much that I think that there are many other people that would totally enjoy hearing her stories as well. And they're fascinating. She's not the type of person that wants to capitalize on anybody. It's not that at all. It's somebody's story of experiences that she had in her life. And they're fascinating stories, or wonderful stories, that need to be shared with other people, because if she doesn't tell them, nobody will ever know. That they'll be just little treasures in her heart, which is fine. But I think that it would be very fun for other people to hear these stories, not just me. So one day I'm playing video games. These gamers go online and they go live, and they're just hanging out, and they're just talking about what they're interested in. And I was sitting there and thinking, geez, Daryn and I could do that. So one day we were on a little trip together, and I said, Daryn, we should do a YouTube channel together. And she said, yes, let's do it.
I just happen to have a YouTube channel that hasn't really done anything in years. And why don't we do that? And she had a show, which she'll probably start up when she has some free time, which isn't while we're together. But all about her cooking and being plant-based. Mm-hmm. And she has thousands of people following her doing that. And now we're being crazy and just having fun.
We're doing
on the fly.
We're reminiscing. There's reminiscing of some of those great things that we experienced in our life with Daryn, which is way more fascinating than mine. but I had some really fascinating opportunities too. And so we're going to be sharing those experiences with you, and then bring you up to present.
Along with loving living in Mexico and how two women can go and have these adventures and have a blast together.
That's right. That's right.
That's because we love Mexico.
So we're two silly expats.
She speaks Spanish and I don't. And yesterday was my 3-year streak of every single day doing Duolingo. Hello, not a good advertisement for Duolingo.
Now she needs to talk to a real person. But you're going to see in our adventures that her Spanish is coming along.
Oh, when I drink tequila, it gets really good.
I have the privilege of producing and editing the show. I don't have a lot of experience. I don't really know what I'm doing. So people can't exactly crawl into my brain to try to figure out this massive train track that's going on, or as my husband says, Mexican electric. You know, I'm trying to learn how to tell our story where it makes sense to everybody.
She has become a fabulous producer. She works my tail off having to do things or pick up shots or whatever it is. And you're really good at what you do. I'm totally impressed. And I have produced, not on a little camera or anything like that, but with a crew where they do all the camera work and they do everything.
And we're completely unscripted and on the fly.
Yes.
One thing, neither one of us could read a teleprompter or anything.
No.
It would sound natural.
Tried that awful. With some show they were doing here. They asked me to do it for some travel show in Mexico, and I realized I am not good at that.
Don't take us too seriously.
But we're being funny because we're having fun, not because we're trying to pretend like we're having fun.
Exactly. That would be unnatural.
Unnatural, no.
No, we like the natural and the
the
organic.
Okay, but you are my producer. I don't see something until she's edited it. So all these things she puts in about my life or anything, I'm not the one that tells her to do it. She finds them online. I don't even know where she finds these things. I'm amazed. But she's inside that brain of hers. It's really cool. And I thank God that he brought in a producer editor that is so much fun to be with.
Thank you.
Let's do this thing.
Okay. So we thank you for tuning in and watching, and we hope that you enjoy our adventures.
Absolutely. Come on board.
Like
and subscribe. But also, let us hear from you. Let's have a comment or two. Hello. Are you there?